Go out the way we came in and get on the main highway going west. Don't go back through the city. Go right up here. So how's it feel to be back?
Good. I feel a lot better with some money in my pocket.
Hey, what's the rush? Money don't buy you happiness, you know.
Get the fuck out of here.
I was just fucking with you. Don't worry about the money. This little job is just the beginning. Pretty soon you'll be rolling in it.
So, Sand Island's still the same shithole it was when I left?
No, no, the place actually ain't too bad now.
Oh, shit. How the hell that happened?
All the moolies flew south for the winter. Of course it's still a shithole, Vito. You only been gone a couple of years. Gonna take a lot longer than that for that neighborhood to turn around. Them people multiply like rabbits. What are you gonna do? It's even worse than when we was kids. They even got some kind of gang there now. What's their fucking name? The Beamers, the Boomers, something like that. I don't fucking know.
No, that's just fucking great.
Hey, what are you worried about? They're animals. All they do is sell dope and kill each other. They ain't gonna bother a guy like you. And even if they do, that's why I gave you that pistol.
Oh, by the way, you're carrying a gun now? What's the deal with that?
Can't do business without it these days, especially in this fucking neighborhood.
You, really know how to inspire confidence, you know that?
Take a left up here.
Wow, I forgot how nice this neighborhood was. You know something? One of these days, I'm gonna buy a house here.
Look at this guy. Ain't even back a day, and he's too good for his old neighborhood.
Hey, what are you breaking my balls for? I'm just window shopping. It'll be years before I could afford a place like this.
You got champagne tastes and beer pockets, my friend. Don't worry, though. I'm gonna help you change that. It's that cream-colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to and go. I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
Hey, what if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test. If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right, just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
What's your poison, Jack?
Shut up, boy. Drink all.
How about one for the road?
Drink all night, and son, you know that that ain't right.
Well, Pappy, you just get
that. Hey! Shut up,
boy.
Beat it!
Boy,
your problem, Jack.
Oh,
you doing over there?
Ah, shit.
What you doing, motherfucker?
Hey, mission accomplished. How'd it go?
Yeah, piece of cake. Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunters, their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Oh, nice. No stains. Clean.
The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like your buddy, Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. I'll see you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
All right, let's go home. I'm exhausted. We should take the highway, Vito. All right, you pulled off that job without fucking it up. Nice going.
Yeah, but I almost got my ass kicked. I didn't live through the war just to die in Sand Island.
Hey, that's all part of the deal, pal. Take it or leave it. Besides, it ain't like you're qualified for anything else.
I guess you're right.
Don't worry about it. It's all gonna be a piece of cake.
So, what's the story with Bruski?
Mike's a good guy to know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always got a scam going. He deals with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I heard he used to stick up gas stations back in the day.
You gonna make him pay the cleaning bill for your jacket?
Nah, I'll let that one slide. I do a lot of business with the guy. Plus, he's got one hell of a temper. One time we was at the track, and some mitt spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye. For a lousy 10 bucks, you believe that shit?
Sounds like kind of a scumbag.
Hey, you just gotta know how to handle these people. And Mike's a pussycat compared to some of the guys I met since you shipped out. You'll see.
Hey, is there a safe place to park around here? I don't want to leave this thing out in the street.
Yeah, that's why you're parking your car next to mine in the garage. The streets are full of criminals these days.
Yeah, the neighborhood ain't what it used to be, huh?
If you're hungry, there's some food in the refrigerator. You hungry, Vito? Take whatever you want from the fridge.
Joe's pleasure, pal. It's Vito speaking.
Vito, why didn't you come home last night? I was worried sick.
Mama? I didn't know you had Joe's number. And whose phone is this?
So have you spoken to Mr. Pappalardo? Find yourself a job?
Yeah, he told me to come by and see him today. Hopefully he's got some work for me.
Okay, Vito. Good luck, mio bambino.
All right, bye, Mama.
Oh, hi there.
What's the matter? Nothing good on the radio?
Mind your beeswax, kid.
Want to be on the front lines of decency and all that is good.
If you don't turn that crap down, I'm gonna call the cops!
Remember, you can't.
Bonjour, sir.
How may I help you, sir?
Voilà, it suits you well. Anything else I can do for you?
Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris. In an update to an earlier story we brought you here at Press Radio News, the massive bombing by U.S. and British air forces of the German city...
Come back anytime, sir.
Thank you.
Well, close the door. It's windy. What do you want?
Yeah, I'm looking for a Mr. Papalotto.
Oh, yeah? Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Papalotto at your service. You can call me Derek. I think I remember your dad. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
He's dead.
Oh, well, we all gotta go sometime. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
Follow me. Load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get $10. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
Oh, yeah, this is gonna be a lot of fun. Who the fuck wants to move boxes around all goddamn day? Jeez, all this for 10 lousy bucks? You gotta be kidding me. Oh, how can these guys stand this? I'm doing this for 5 fucking minutes, I already hate it. You know what? I don't need this chicken shit money.
Hey, you done?
Yeah, I'm done. And you can keep the $10. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here, then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit, nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for $10. What the hell are you doing? Come with me.
What now?
Well, this one don't like manual labor.
What the fuck?
Said he works with Joe Barbaro.
Bullshit. Who wanna load crates if he works with Joe? You'll have to explain this one to me, sonny boy. What's your story?
Well, my mother wanted me to come talk to you about an honest job, but I need some real money, so this ain't gonna cut it.
Them women, they're all the same. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
She doesn't want you hanging around with Joe, right? My mother was the same way. Look what become of me. Union boss. I got the whole fucking waterfront under my thumb. So how's Joe?
Pretty good, I guess.
How'd you meet up with him?
Oh, we go way back to the old neighborhood. I just come back from overseas and he's putting me up until I can get back on my feet.
Listen, you gotta understand, a person in my position has gotta be careful.
Certainly.
So you won't mind if I give Joe a call, right?
Nah, go ahead.
Now, where'd I put his number? Hey, here it is. Might not be home. That wouldn't be good. Hi, Joe. Hey, this is Derek. Listen, I got this guy here. What'd you say your name was?
Vito.
Vito. He's looking for a job. He says he's a friend of yours. A good friend. I just wanted to check with you first. Uh-huh. Sure. War hero and all that shit. All right, all right. Thanks, then. I'll talk to you later. Sorry, pal. I had to check you out. Joe says you just come back from Italy. You must be able to handle yourself. You want to make a little more money? I got just the thing. The guys here at the port are supposed to pay a monthly fee to the barber, but half of them never cough it up. I need someone to give them a little nudge. $10 a man.
What if they don't need a haircut?
Well, then you'll have to convince them otherwise.
I see. What if somebody makes a fuss?
Then you kick the shit out of them.
Well, let's say you teach them a lesson that doesn't require that they miss work. You got it? Which is why Steve ain't doing the job. Right, Steve?
Right, boss.
Collect at least $150, I give you 50. Just for walking around, taking in the sea air and meeting new people. Easy fucking money, eh? What do you say?
Yeah, hey, it's better than lugging crates around.
All right, then. Get going.
I'm here to collect the fee for the barber.
Hey, what kind of game you playing here?
The kind where you pay what you owe and you don't get hurt. You got a problem with that?
I got a problem with you. Now get out of here before I kick your ass. Here's your fucking money.
Yeah, glad you decided to reconsider. I got his money already. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Yeah. I must have forgot or something.
Next time, try to pay on time, okay? Thanks. Hey. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Sure, here it is. I don't want no problems.
Don't leave it until the last minute next time. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Look, asshole. I'm not in the mood. Why don't you get out of my face before you get hurt?
No can do, pal. Derek wants his money.
Derek can kiss my ass. What's that fat fuck gonna do? Have me killed?
Hey, you said it, not me.
Why don't you give it a try then, asshole? Tear him a new one!
Anybody else got a fucking problem with paying for the fucking barber?
Here's the money, boss man.
Good job. Here's your share. I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain. Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. And say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, we'll do. I'll see you later.
And Vito, I almost forgot. Joe called. He wants you should meet him at Freddy's.
What would you like? There you go, drink up.
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. I think he's got something big for us.
Yeah, no shit?
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shuttle. Here, he's coming. Don't say nothing stupid. Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hiya, Joe. This the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry.
You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen, I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
Where can we get them?
Any office of price administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Aniello. Here's the address. Tell her I sent you.
All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
But what's the job pay?
I'll give you $600 for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, we're in.
No, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe.
So? What do you say, Vito?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you. You never know what's gonna happen. Better to be safe than sorry. I got beef.
Wait. This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back in, we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see
you. Good luck, Vito.
Yeah, can I help you?
Yeah, hello, ma'am. Henry Tomasino sent me. He said you might be able to help me with a little problem down at the Office of Price Administration.
Yeah, I heard about that. What do you need from me?
I need to get in there tonight.
All right, tell you what. My sister's in the hospital right now. If you give me a lift over there, I'll tell you everything you need to know. It's right across the street from the OPA, so it ain't like you're gonna be going out of your way.
Sure, no problem.
Okay, let's go. And take it easy behind the wheel, all right? I seen the way you kids drive these days. All right, kid. The place is locked up pretty tight at night, so you gotta get into the back.
They keep the back door open at night?
No, but the basement window usually is, so that's how you can get in. You're looking for the safe, right?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. It's on the top floor. So's the director's office. That's where the keys are.
Okay, so I go in through a window around the back, then head upstairs to the director's office, right?
Right. And be careful, there's guards in there at night. Don't let them see you.
right, kid. Drop me at the hospital right here. The office is across the street. Okay, thanks for the ride, kid.
Thanks, Maria. I'll see you.